Hey guys, Welsknight here, bringing you another brand new episode of Welsknight's Realm, my single player vanilla series. And in today's episode, we are going to be building ourselves something that is long overdue. And that, my friends, is an enchanting house. So, let's go ahead and lay this thing out. I have a few ideas. I'm thinking spruce for the front. And I'm thinking we'll do something a little bit like, let's go maybe here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like that maybe. And then we'll go back to count over to place one there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, bam. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, here. Well, it's probably easier to just go 1, 2, bam. And then here? Is that right? No, here. So I'm thinking something like that should work. And this will be kind of the town center. Although I think I would like the whole thing better if it moved one block this way. That's what I'm thinking. Sometimes you have to adjust your placement so that it fits the landscape and the area around it a little bit better. There we go. There. Now let's take a look at it from over here. Yeah, that looks like a much better spot. That looks much, much more along the lines of what I'm looking for. So let's go 1, 2. Oh, derped up. There we go. And we're just going to build each of these pillars up 3 tall, I think. And actually, let's put one more pillar right here. Do any of you recognize this build? Anyone? Maybe. If you do, leave it in the comments down below. I'm curious to see if any of you will recognize this or not. And it won't be exactly the same, but it'll be close. So, we got that going for us. We got the spruce. I think that looks good. Now, let's go. Do I want to use oak for the walls? Maybe. Maybe not. Maybe we'll do, or we could go. Lots of decisions. I think I do want to have a chest so that I actually can put some of this stuff away while I'm figuring things like this out. And we've got 16 bookshelves. I know we only need 15, but I'm going to go with a design that's symmetrical as opposed to one that is efficient. Yeah, I think oak for the walls might be the way to go. That's kind of what I'm thinking. Maybe dark oak roof? Or maybe spruce walls, dark oak roof, and oak floors. I might prefer that. There we go. Let's take a nap. Okay. Let's see. Or one final thing that I hadn't considered that I think I'm actually going to go with. I think we're going to go birch floor. We'll go birch floor because we're going to have oak incorporated through the bookshelves themselves, because the bookshelves themselves have kind of an oak texture to them. So, let's get the walls in place first. We'll go spruce. No, we said oak walls. Wait a minute. I don't even know what I said anymore. I'm getting so confused. Yeah, let's go spruce walls. It'll make sense. It'll fit with the rest of the town. There we go. So we'll just build this. Like so. Leave room for a doorway there. And like that. And there we go. Then here we do a 3x3. Like this. Here. We do one of those. And bring that around like that. There we go. Good. That's how it's supposed to look. Okay. Next step. Stairs. We're going to put a spruce stair here and here. We'll put spruce stairs. Actually, you know what? Let's make this build just a little bit bigger. Just a little bit. Then it might be too high. No, it won't. These things are huge. Never mind. It will not be too high if we raise it up like one level. So I'm going to grab a little bit more spruce wood. And we'll just go 1, 2, 3, jump, 4, jump, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There we go. And then spruce planks on top of all of the spots that we already have spruce planks. Not there. That is not a correct location for a spruce plank. Here we go. And there. There we go. That looks pretty good, I think. Now we will take our spruce stairs and do a little bit of this action right here. Oh, I'm a derp. I just totally messed this up, I realized. Let me fix this real quick, guys. I need to bring this wall out another 2, and I'll be back in just a moment. All right, guys, I am back, and I've got it all figured out. I just basically brought that chunk of the wall, this side of the building out, an extra 2 blocks that way. Because I just realized as I was doing this that if I was doing it the old way, I was not going to leave myself with enough space to actually do what I want to do with this building, and that is make an enchanting area. So, that's all right. Now, as some of you may recognize, this is one of my 15-minute builds, and this particular one is what we're building right now is essentially a slightly larger version of one of the 15-minute builds, and slightly modified in materials and stuff to fit a little bit better in our world as well. But some of you will probably recognize it. There we go. That looks pretty good. That looks pretty good indeed. Okay, now let's go ahead. Let's go ahead and go to the chest is what we should go ahead and do. Go ahead, grab ourselves some cobble. And we're going to put cobble on top of you and you, and you, 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 and you. Okay, now, we're going to take this cobble, and we're going to build up a platform just like this. Do it here as well. I can't make that. Oh, this would be so much easier if I could fly, but that would take all the fun out of survival building. Okay, here we go. There we go. Made it. And over, up, like so. There we go. So we'll have something that looks like this, and then we can go ahead and take out these underneath cobblestone blocks right there. So we'll have basically a giant triangle that looks like that. Now, this is not going to work quite as well as the other house did, the actual 15-minute build version. And the reason for that is that that one, this roof right here, and these two edges were the same height. So we'll have to do some tricky things, kind of modifying the build once again for our purposes, but that's fine. Sometimes you have to do that kind of stuff, and it's really not that big of a deal. There we go. Oh, wait a minute. Back down. Over, up. There we go. So you got that going. And take out those blocks. Beautiful. So far, so good. Now we're going to go back to our spruce stairs, which it appears we're going to have to make several more of, which is fine. There we go. We're going to go back to our spruce stairs, and I'm going to put spruce stairs coming out from right here, coming out from the cobblestone. Just on these edges, though. We're not doing anything with the little side. Oh, come on now. Oh. Ah, whatever. There's one stair that's trapped up there, but I'll worry about getting it later. There we go. So it's going to go like that. And this one we don't do that with. And this one we do. Oh, come on now. Do what you're supposed to. Okay. There we go. Now, roof. I'm thinking dark oak roof. Those are just my thoughts. I think a dark oak roof will look quite good. In this case, anyway. So, let's go up there and work on that just a little bit. I don't think I'm going to do the entire roof on camera. I'll just kind of give you guys the basic idea. And that should be fine. If I can find a good place to get up there. Right here. That looks acceptable. That'll do. Okay. Oh, and I need cobblestone stairs. And some cobblestone blocks themselves. There we go. So, the way that I'm intending to do this roof is basically to take stone brick, or to take dark oak stairs, essentially coming out of where the cobblestone is. There we go. Just like... Oh, man, these are so hard to place from this angle. There we go. There's one, two, three. There. So it'll look like this, basically. And I think that's going to be... Yeah, that should be good. And then down below, we'll go like that. We'll go... This one is being blocked, I think. Yeah, we'll go like that. And then we'll do one here. Actually, you know what? I think this one actually is not there at all. In fact, I'm quite sure that it's not. And this one is going to be a major pain to place, isn't it? There we go. Looking good. Okay, so we'll have a roof that comes up like this. And then, I can't make that. Let's try that one more time. Oh, bother. Fine. I'll do it this way, because I'm terrible at parkour. Here, we will put one of those. On top of that, we will put an upside-down stair like this. And then we're going to put a stone, or a cobblestone step. And I don't have any cobblestone slabs, do I? Of course not. Why would I carry one of the things with me that I actually need to complete this? That would be foolish of me. Let's make a few. And we put a slab there, slab here. Step and step. And then once we actually get down here to the bottom, we put another one out like this. And that one goes there. So, looks pretty good, I think. So it's going to be a roof like this. We'll have spruce back there behind it. And that's pretty much it. Now, I'm going to go ahead and finish up the rest of the roof. And I will be back with you in just a moment. All right, guys, I am back. It's now morning, and look at the roof. Looks pretty good, I think. Looks pretty good. Turned out pretty well. So, next step, I believe, is getting the floor in place. And I think two sets of slabs will be enough. Pretty sure it will be. And we're going to put birch floors in here. That is going to provide a very significant contrast with the spruce sides and also with the oak bookshelves that we're going to use in here for the actual enchanting area, which I think is going to go right about here or so. So let's see if we put this away. Let's start laying. I just had a thought. Let's run up to the house real quick and get glass window panes. Because one thing that I had not considered was if window panes will connect to bookshelves. And I think they will. And if that's the case, that could potentially cause us some issues, maybe. I suppose we could work around it, though. In fact, I know exactly how we'll work around it, because I don't really want the bookshelves to be visible from outside right up against the window anyway. So I know exactly what we'll do. We'll just extend this like so. Oh, messed that one up. There we go. We'll extend that like that. Bookshelf will go right here. Okay. So, we'll put this stuff in. Enchanting table would go right here. Bookshelves would go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we'd have, let's see. 1, 2, like that, and is it like this? Is that right? I don't remember. I think it was like that. Do I have any? I do not. Let's just make a wooden shovel quick so I can test this out. Yeah, okay, that does give us level 30 in chance, which is what we want. Sweet. Okay, now, next step, we need a torch up here, as well as a torch here and here. And I just noticed a mistake. Easy to fix, but a mistake nonetheless. There we go. That's much better. Okay. So, let's put in our glass panes. And I'm just going to make a bunch, because if nothing else, I'm sure they'll get used at other builds and projects throughout here, throughout this village anyway. So, I'm not really worried about making too many. Let's go ahead and do some of this, some of that. There we go. Looks good. Look. Yeah. All right. That looks pretty good. So we got a level 30 enchants. Now we need to do something with the ceiling. And I think I know exactly what I'm going to do up there. Let's actually take birchwood planks. And we're basically just going to fill in this ceiling. Like this. Because it's not going to be visible. There's nothing up there that I need to worry about. There's no reason for me to go up there whatsoever. So all I'm going to do is block it off. And if there's a couple block mistakes and stuff, it's not even a big deal. There we go. So we got our birch ceiling, we got our birch floors. That's looking good. I do think we need something up there. So, negligent discharge. It fell. It fired on accident. There we go. Let's do that. Actually, let's jump in here real quick. And while I'm up here, I want to torch those two areas just so there is some actual light coming back from here. There we go. We'll put you there. You go there. And you go there. Yeah, that's pretty good. Now we need to do something with this, because that side of the house is looking rather bland, shall we say. So, let's try out some cobblestone walls, just like this. And if that doesn't work, I'll go with dark oak fences. I think I would prefer the dark oak fences. I think those would look better. So let's go for dark oak fences. I don't need a ton of them. Actually, I will need significantly more because I forgot that I need to do a pretty significant portion of the house like this. So let's just make... probably going to need even more than that. Let's just make a bunch. There we go. 48, that's a pretty good start. And then we'll just do that and maybe bring those across. Yeah, that works. Then we're doing dark oak fences there. Dark oak fences here. These, we'll maybe get to. These for sure, I want dark oak fences around. How many do we have left? We got plenty left. Let's just go ahead and do those two corners. Actually, let's not do those. Let's not do these two. But we will do that corner and that. There we go. So that looks much better. Especially once we close the door. Actually, you know what? You know what? Just for the sake of color, I'm going to put a dark oak door on this. Yeah, that's a little bit better. That's not bad for an enchanting house. Not bad at all. So, anvil I need. It will need a chest in it with lapis. Let's put the anvil maybe over... How do I want to do that? Maybe we'll say anvil corner over here or something. And then lapis chest will go over here. I think we're good, though. And I'll do a little bit of landscaping and stuff like that to kind of tidy it up. I'll do that later. But I think we're pretty much out of time for this episode, guys. So if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps out my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.